Student Kevin Troy asks, we've seen in this unit the use of import time to get access to time.clock. Can you talk about the basics of libraries, what they are, how they work, etc.?
Okay, this is good, because I don't think I explained really what's going on when I used that. What import does is just bring a library into your execution environment. So you can have a library that defines different variables, defines functions, defines anything that you would define in your own Python code. And then when you import it, you get access to all of that, but it's not in your own file. And having libraries is really useful. It limits the size of the file that you have to deal with. It protects the namespace. So if everything that was defined as part of the standard library was always available and you didn't have to import it, there would be many more names that you have to worry about using because they already have some other predefined meaning. So libraries are really useful. You can make your own libraries. We're not going to cover that in CS101. But as you start to build bigger programs, it's really important to think about how to structure your program so you don't end up with one huge file with lots of code that no one can figure out what's going on. So libraries are a very useful way to do that.